It's a Great Big Shame by Edgar Bateman. I've lost my pal. He's the best in all the town. But don't you think him dead, because he ain't. But since he's wed, he's had to knuckle down. It's enough to wax the temper of a saint. He's a brewer's drayman with a leg of mutton fist, and as strong as a bullock or a Norse. Yet in her hands he's like a little kid. Oh, I wish as I could get him a divorce. It's a great big shame, and if she belonged to me, I'd let her know who's who, nagging at a fellow what is 6'3", and her nubbet 4'2". Oh, they hadn't been married not a month or more, when underneath her thumb goes Jim. Isn't it a pity that the likes of her should put upon the likes of him? Now Jim was class. He could sing a decent song, and at scrapping he had won some great renown. It took 2 coppers for to make him move along, and another 6 to hold the fella down. But today, when I asks us, would he come and have some beer? To the doorstep on tiptoe he arrives. I dasn't, says he. Don't shout, gosh, you'll hear. I've got to clean the windows and the knives. Ah, it's a great big shame. And if she belonged to me, I'd let her know who's who. Nagging at a fellow what is 6'3", and her nubbet 4'2". Oh, they hadn't been married not a month or more, when underneath her thumb goes Jim. Isn't it a pity that the likes of her should put upon the likes of him? On a Sunday morn, with a dozen pals or more, he'd play at pitch and toss along the lee, but now she bullies him, a scrubbing of the floor. Such a change, well, I never did see. With apron on him, I twigged him on his knees, a-rubbing up the old half stone. What with emptying the ashes and a shelling of the peas, I'm blowed if he can call himself his own. Ah, it's a great big shame, and if she belonged to me, I'd let her know who's who, nagging at a fella what is 6'3", and her only 4'2". Oh, they hadn't been married not a month, no more, when underneath her thumb goes Jim. Ah, isn't it a pity that the likes of her should put upon the likes of him?